Welcome back, everyone, to another exciting episode of Right Man in the Wrong Place. My name is Luke Tatum. I react to music. Today, we are going to, I think if I'm understanding what we're doing, we're watching Dennis Chambers, who is, from what I understand, a very funky drummer. He is going to listen to Tool for the first time, and I believe the song he's going to hear is Schism, which is a wonderful song, and he doesn't know what the drum part sounds like. So he's going to be sitting at a drum set and try to figure out how to play the drums for Schism without having the drum track in the mix. This was requested in the comments, and I hit record without realizing that I should go back and figure out who it was that said that. So I'm going to try to go back and remember who said that and find the comment again. Y'all leave so many dang comments, it's a little bit difficult to sift through them whenever I'm actually looking for something now. I did at the very beginning of the channel, I was taking screenshots and I was very methodical, and it just takes too long now. So anyway, I'm going to try to figure out what it was, but from memory, that's what I have here. I just made a little note on my Trello board that I use to keep track of requests. Tool, Dennis Chambers, Schism, ? And I think this is the video. It's over on Drumeo. Of course, as always, I'm going to link the original video in the description. Looks like it's almost 12 minutes here. And this should be fantastic, but I don't know. Like, I've got the drum part to Schism pretty ingrained in my brain, so I have no idea what's about to happen. All right, this came out May 23rd, 2022 is the look of it, and I am really excited, but I don't know what I'm necessarily getting into, so let's do it.
Okay, I got a problem with this. This is not my type of thing, but okay. So I get the gist of what it is, but I'll make an attempt. But I'm just telling you, if somebody were to send me something like this, I would say no. This is not me. Hi, Dennis Chambers here. Just want to give you a little insight on my learning curve or the process of what I do when I first hear a song for the first time. I sit and listen to it first, dissect it, and then try to play it. The artist is Tool. And the song is called Schism. Schism.
The band is Tool. The song is Schism.
Schism. The song is called Schism, and the group's called Tool.
Just to be able to go back and hear Tool for the first time would be so great, right? Been listening to them for years and years and years. Oh, okay, so we can hear the drums, but he can't. Drumming is very, like, mathematical, right? There's plenty of research out there connecting music and math and all that, so I don't necessarily need to say that, but percussion particularly, because you have to subdivide a lot to figure out how you're going to do that. And even among percussive tracks, I think you have to know that Tool is very mathematical, even to another level beyond just, you know, standard mainstream rock music, right? So this should be very, very interesting. I've heard Dennis Chambers before. I know who he is.
I mean, I got a problem with this.
I don't know who he is, but I've heard the name. I misspoke there. So I'm sure he's, you know, an excellent drummer. I just don't know where he's going to go with it.
This is not my type of thing.
And that's why we chose the song.
Uh-huh. Okay. All right. See, in my younger days, this would be right up my goddamn alley here.
We're gonna open the video with that.
That's a great song, man. I gotta get that. And which album is that off of?
Is it Lateralus? Lateralus.
So, okay. Listening to this for the first time, the first thing I listened for is the style. Second thing I listened to was the time signature, just like anybody else. This song seemed like it's drifting in and out of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So 6, 7, and then in the bridge it drifts into 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 4 and 6, if I remember correctly. So it's just to catch those two things and bring them together and try to you know, play the song. Also listening to what the bass is doing, which I'm not sure if I mean, I know there's bass there, I just couldn't hear it too well. Just want to put the disclaimer in there, okay? This is not my cup of tea of doing this. So I'm going to give it a shot.
He's just saying he's doing it under duress, right? I used to be really good and I used to key in on time signatures really well back when I was in the band. So if you're new to the channel, like I was section leader of the drum line my senior year of high school. I was in drum line. I played bass drum freshman, sophomore, junior year, and then I played snare my senior year. And we kind of had like a co-section leader thing. So I was like one of two section leaders in the drum line. But, you know, so I used to be all about that stuff. Like, you know, I was listening to Tool even back then. And now, I mean, it's not like I use that on a daily basis, right? So like I've forgotten the names of some of the rudiments for drums and stuff like that, right? So, you know, I'm more of a casual musician now. Like I don't have a drum set anymore. I don't have a room for one. So, you know, for what that's worth, but I can't imagine hearing without the drums, because it's like the drums, Danny Carey is so integral to every Tool song. I just can't imagine. I wonder if you can find that on YouTube, like, without the drum track. Anyway, let's go.
Okay. This is not my cup of tea of doing this.
It's not my cup
of tea. So I'm going to give it a shot.
So the performance you're about to see from Dennis is a pretty funky interpretation of the song Schism.
Oh, don't ruin
and
it
if you
for
want
me.
To know more about how Dennis gets this funk sound on the drums and really how he approaches music, you can check out his course on funk drumming inside of Drumeo. You can click the link right below this video to get a 7-day trial and check it out for yourself. Right now, let's check out Dennis's full performance of Schism by Tool.
Okay, I'm gonna cut that out. So watching this, I just cut out a little plug that Drumeo had for their own product. So we're just going to listen to music because that's what we're here to do.
Well, let's check out Dennis's full performance of Schism by Tool.
I like his Pearl drum set, by the way. It's very nice. It's pretty color. There's a lot of like, should I play a note here? He's not, yeah, okay, so drummers sometimes, if you're playing all of the drum set, you're kind of doing some real intense fills and stuff, and you're not playing like exactly what is on the album version. A lot of times you'll like throw your arms up or one of your arms will be up and you're like you're playing with your double bass pedal, you're playing with this hand. And then you're like, I don't know where this hand is going to come down. And so you'll see, you know, like this sometimes drummers or even like this, like, I don't know what I'm going to play yet. He's not doing that because he's not like playing like, you know, metal drumming, arms up kind of crazy right now. He may do that. I don't know. But so he's not doing that, but you can sort of tell it's like, you know, should I play here? And, you know, gosh, poor guy, like, what a song to throw at somebody. I mean, he did a good job catching the transition to the next phase of the song. I think it's phenomenal. I do like his kind of groove that he's established. It's just some of the fills and stuff where he's sort of having that, like, One little thing I noticed, you will have to try to catch it at the next transition. I'm not going to keep backing up the video, but he's got a little piece of tape on the snare. So as a non-drummer, you may not know, like, what the heck is that for? You'll see this little blue piece of tape kind of at the top where the logo on the snare drum head is. And it's just to reduce the amount of vibration a little bit. It makes it a little bit more of a sound instead of quite as much vibration. It's a little bit funkier. You know, back when I had a drum set, I used to keep like a piece of cloth, like a microfiber cloth, and I would keep it on there and have some tape to keep it in place. You'll even have people like keep a bag of something to weight it down on the drum. And it's like, you don't always want that for every song, for every style, but certainly like if you're doing jazz drumming or something, it's probably more the sound you want. His placement of like the bass kick is really interesting too. Sucks, man. As a drummer, like, that sucks. It's like, band, what are you doing? Please stop. Right, because in the original mix, right, you've got all the instruments playing together. It's a very unifying moment. And, I mean, how is he going to know after one listen exactly where that is? Like, that would be crazy if he had nailed it. But yeah, you know, okay, I'm just going to play on the hi-hats. Safe move, totally agree with it. I mean, it sounds good. I like adding all those snare hits in there. That actually sounds really cool. It's like almost a punk thing. Oh my gosh, that's so weird without the drums. Of course, there is no drumming here in the original. Gosh, I mean, that's a whole thing too, right? Like in Tool, I mean, there are entire stretches of time, long stretches of time occasionally without any percussion. God, that's weird. Here you just kind of start having fun, right? I notice he's retreating to the hi-hats. Nice safe space, get your foot off the kick pedal, just, you know, like, okay, let them do what they're doing. The band is being weird right now. I'm just gonna play on the hi-hat. It's totally fine. Okay. I say don't get on the pedal, but here we go. He feels it building. He probably remembers that it does build again. Good. Good stuff. You know, it'd be really cool. It'd be cool during this Cold Silence has a tendency to this segment. It'd be really cool to kind of do like a leading bass hit. You know, if I was going to do an alternate take on the drums of Schism, which is not something I ever thought I would be talking about at all, but it would be really cool to kind of do like a heartbeat kind of thing, like a like that kind of a pattern through here. I think that would have a really cool kind of reinterpretation of it. But I mean, this is just crazy. This is fun. I think that would be cool. When is the build happening? When is the build happening?
That was my first attempt of playing that song. I noticed at the end.
What a rude thing. Like, I mean, truly, like, what a horrible thing to inflict on somebody. Hey, just play this real quick, right? Because, I mean, if you did this song or if you did The Grudge or several other songs that just end, you know, like it builds and builds and builds and it's just over. The Pot would be another song that does that. How are you going to keep track? Because you're trying to go, okay, what's the time signature here? Okay. And you're trying to set a groove and come up with your next fill while you're playing your next bar and all that. And then, oh yeah, the song's over. Whoops. You're just... I mean, that's embarrassing, right? So props to Dennis for putting up with that.
It's some figures that was going down. But since I don't have isolated tracks to hear what's going on, I just played whatever I felt over that. And I'm quite sure it was wrong, but it felt great to me.
So hopefully you enjoyed that incredible performance from Dennis Chambers. I know I never thought I would ever see Dennis playing a Tool song, but there you go, it happened. Now, if you want to learn Schism for yourself, we have a full note-for-note transcription inside of Drumeo where you can slow down the parts, you can loop different sections, and you can just practice along with the interactive player and learn it for yourself. So if you want to try it out, click the link right below this video. You can get a 7-day trial to Drumeo for free, and I hope to see you there.
I might leave the Drumeo plugs in there. I said I was going to edit them out, so if you hear me say that, I just changed my mind. That is cool. That is super cool to have the actual sheet music. I have a very hard time reading drum sheet music, I'm just going to be honest. I just like to improvise as I go, but, you know, whatever. That was a blast. Totally fun, totally awesome. I, you know, feel bad for the guy. I really do. Here's the most complex thing we could possibly come up with to put in front of you. Good luck. Let's do it once. No drum track. Go for it. It'd be one thing to go, here it is with the drum track. We want you to play kind of your version of this. And I get what they're doing. I get what they're doing. But, you know, just the time signature, the feel of each segment is so integral in a Tool track. That is wild. So, wow. I know Drumeo also did something with Mike Portnoy here recently. I believe it was something with Pull Me Under. I have not watched that yet. That might be a fun reaction to do if y'all like this. Mike Portnoy is my favorite drummer. The drummer for Dream Theater. Of course, he also did other stuff like he did the Winery Dogs and some of these other bands, but I think Dream Theater's always been kind of his home. I'm really glad that he's coming back to the band. So if you like this kind of thing, if you like drum reactions, please tell me. I'd be more than happy to do his Drumeo stuff on here, presuming it's on YouTube available to watch for free. I hope it would be, but that would be just awesome. Pull Me Under is a legendary track, if that's the right track. I'm going to stop because I have no idea what I'm talking about at this point. That was super fun. Thank you to whoever it was that requested that. Again, I will try to do a screenshot if I can find the comment. If it was you and I just forgot and can't find the comment, please just let me know that you watched this. Let me know if you like the reaction. But that was great. I could definitely see myself doing more of this type of thing if it's something y'all want to watch. Anyway, thank you very much. If you have a request and you'd like to make sure I get to it on some sort of reasonable timetable instead of just maybe someday, forever into the future, then hey, buy me a coffee. That's right there. And I would love to hear what is on your mind, what you'd like me to hear, what you'd like to see me hear and hear with me while I see it for the first time. Yeah. Until next time, just remember the right man in the wrong place can make all the difference in the world.